So focus on the week.
9 months into it, and it's finally here. How excited are you for game week, the anticipation and everything?
It's intense, man, but I love this. I can't wait to go out there and see how we perform Saturday, just because we've been going at each other, you know, all the spring, all the camp. Just us being on one sideline again, just that focus intensity that Coach Venables always talks about. I can't wait to see it.
How have you grown as a player from last December to now?
Definitely a lot of changes. I went from being one of the youngest guys to one of the oldest like that. So it's now more of a leadership role, and with leadership comes confidence. You know, you have to be decisive as a leader in order to lead the other guys. So it's more about focusing on the standard, setting the standard, and paying it forward for, because I'm not going to always be here. So paying it forward for 10, 20 years down the line when we come back and they've had their seventh national championship in a row or something like that. And, you know, seeing that those guys are doing the same stuff that we were doing. So it's really just confidence and just more focused on just not just myself, but the group as a whole, how we're doing.
What are you most excited about? Fans, people outside the program, seeing about this defense on Saturday?
Well, you know, Coach Venables always says dirty hard work in the dark. That's what we've done. You know, it's just what you do when the stands are full. Well, that happens. All that starts when the stands are empty. So, again, we had a great spring. We had a great summer with Schmitty. We had a great fall camp. And now it's really just time to go out there and prove it. So as far as stuff that I can't wait to see, man, I just can't wait to see, again, pack the palace. Can't wait to see the fans again. I can't wait to just see all my guys make big plays. And I just can't wait to feel the electricity in Norman, Oklahoma again. So.
You look at last year, and I mean, you flashed a lot, but you also had a guy like Nick Benito out there. Does it come to your mind like, okay, well, people are going to see me as Nick Benito now? Like, I have to do more than just flash.
Yes and no. As far as that's concerned, you always look at just, you don't really compare yourself to the guys who came before you from a playing standpoint, a leadership standpoint, maybe, but we're all unique individuals. So, you know, Nick had a lot of strengths. Nick had his weaknesses. I have my strengths. I have my weaknesses. But as far as people seeing me as, you know, the next defensive end, I relish it. I can't wait. It's an opportunity that I'm blessed to have as far as that's concerned. It's a privilege. It's an honor and a privilege to be an Oklahoma student.
What are those strengths going into this year? It just seems like you're more complete player than maybe you were a year ago.
Yeah, again, that just kind of comes with age. So, like I said, last time I did media, again, the 18-year-old Reggie Grimes is different from the 19-year-old Reggie Grimes. The 20-year-old Reggie Grimes is different from both of those. So it just comes with experience, again, reps, just focus on, again, not myself, but the group, just being the guy.
Reggie, we just talked to Anton. He told us about iron sharpens iron. We talked about how the ants on the team make it look better. Can you tell us about that from your perspective and how these offensive tackles have been shaping up this season?
Absolutely. We have about four or five offensive tackles who are really, really good. Okay, if they're not really, really good, then they're going to be really, really good. So as far as that's concerned, man, it's been a great grind. Again, it's a competition. It's the game within the game. Okay, so if I beat them on this rush, one play, I may not be able to beat them on that same rush that next play because they adapt. You know, it's the game within the game. So you got football, then you got your individual one-on-one battles. So I think with Anton especially, it's been a lot. You know, we've all gone back and forth during camp, and it's been great. I relish it. I'm so excited. I've been really blessed to have that opportunity.
Yeah, Anton said he's about 6'6". Tyler's like 6'7".
Yeah.
How tough is it to get around those guys with those long arms? And who else bothers the defensive end rush like this?
Again, you can't just go up. You can't go up against them like there's just any other person. Again, we are Oklahoma. We're known. One of our strengths historically has been our offensive line. So Coach Bo does a great job with those guys. So you got to be savvy, you know, because they're smart guys too. They aren't just big dumb offensive line. They're guys who know the game. Okay, so they know the game. They know us because they see us every day in practice, as opposed to maybe another team who wouldn't, who would just see us like a week or so. They see us every single day. They've seen us every single day for years at this point. So it's really again more of the game within the game, and just kind of being savvy and know what you can and can't do, and change up rushes. But again, it just makes us all better.
What about a guy in your room, in R. Mason Thomas? Sounds like he's had a really good impression early for a freshman.
Absolutely. Again, I love Mace. Love Mace to death. He always comes to work with a lunch pail mentality, man. Just a blue collar kind of kid. And again, love him. He's a hell of a ball player, hell of a passer. He's really quick, really twitchy. And I can't wait to see what not only what this year holds, but what his future holds.
From what we've seen, I don't know, like in 20 years that I've ever seen a coach put as much of himself as Prippen puts into coaching you guys practice every day, from morning into night. How much does that endear itself to the team, make you guys want to play for him and make you guys want to go out Saturday and make his first game a success?
Coach Venables is the kind of guy that you would love to play for. It's a privilege to play for someone who's been held in such high regard defensively and just coach-wise in football for as long as he has. So the fact that he's now my head coach, man, I love it. And he's a defensive guy. He's a defensive-minded guy. He knows everything that goes on the defense. Okay, so it's more of, again, it's a privilege, it's an honor, but at the same time, it comes with expectation that, you're supposed to do, you got to do your job in this defense. Okay, because if everyone does their job except you, more times than not, a big play is going to happen because of you. And we just got to go out there, we make him proud. We made him proud. We've worked, again, from the spring to the summer to camp to now. Again, he's always tells us he's proud of us. He's proud of us working this way, but it's not enough yet. And it won't be enough right now. And that's okay. So we just realize that competition, we realize that challenge. And we just can't wait to come out Saturday and see what we're made of.
You guys were going through so much when he took over. Do you remember your first impressions when you got out on a practice field with him or everybody? I mean, I have to imagine somewhere along the lines of, what is this guy?
Okay, so the thing about Coach Venables, right? So I originally wanted to go to Clemson. Again, they were my number one for a while, but they offered me. And I didn't pan out. And I was bummed because I wanted to play for a guy like Coach Venables. Because I saw him in Clemson practice. I saw him in games. I was in the locker room with him at Clemson. I've been around him, so he was the kind of guy that I thought, I want to play for him. And it just so happens he came here. I couldn't wait. But now you're on the other side of it as opposed to, a recruitment where you're actually one of these guys, one of these players now. So it's definitely my first impressions of Coach Venables as he was here, as I became one of his players, was this guy gets it. And it's going to be tough. But he coaches his heart, he loves his heart. I think that's the main thing that kind of may get lost just when you're going through it, because he's a very intense person. But he loves us, and I think that's the most important part.
I assume since you knew, it was fun watching other people learn who he was.
Yeah, absolutely.
When he first got here.
Yeah, I mean, again, it was because there are a lot of guys who didn't know Coach Venables, who just knew he was the DC at Clemson for X amount of years, which is fine. But just actually going through, again, our winter workouts and him being out here almost every day was intense. Even through winter workouts was intense. So, again, just kind of watching guys know who he is, adapt to him. We're still all adapting to him. This is our first week one with Coach Venables. But again, it's been an amazing opportunity.
What kept you from going to Clemson? You talked about wanting to and all of that.
There were a few things, man. There were a few things. Eventually, I said I wasn't going to commit anywhere without taking a visit, just because I was kind of slow playing and just kind of just see everywhere. Because I went to almost every major school in the country. Our crew was kind of crazy. It's got the one where they got full, which, kind of sucked. But it was what it was. I wasn't really tripping off it because I knew what kind of guy I was. I knew what kind of player I was. And eventually, one thing led to another, I ended up here, which, again, I loved it. I relished the competition because we're Oklahoma. No one likes Oklahoma. And we don't like anybody. As CK always says, and that's true. So I always wanted to play for a team that was like that. Winning is that I'm a winner. Ethan over there, Ethan's a winner. We love winning. That's what we do. So I wanted to go to a school that won. I wanted to go to a school that I could contribute winning to. And that's what I've done.
Well, it's kind of an off the wall question. I apologize if you've been asked this before, but why 14? Especially on the defensive side of the ball.
Okay, so here's why 14, right? So I was 44, forever growing up. And then again, all through the first few years of high school, I was number 44. And then I transferred high schools, okay? So when I transferred, number 44 was taken by a senior, and I was a senior coming in. And I don't want to be that guy, okay, just to hey, I'm new here. Also, by the way, this number you have for 3 years, I don't want to just take it because, again, I'm nice like I do. So I asked Coach Matt Daniels. I was like, okay, what you have available. They're like, all right, well, 24 is a senior, 34 is a senior. You can have 94. And I was like, I'm not working with that. They're like, okay, well, there's 14, but you may not be able to fit it because that was a medium jersey, by the way. And I was more or less the same size I am now. So I was like, you know, we're just going to make this one work. So put on that tight jersey, and 14, and I liked it. And then I got here, Buki at 44, but I was going to put it over here. 14 still available, so I'm not a little rocky. And then I just kind of fell in love with it through senior year of high school.
Appreciate it.